So welcome. In this video, we are going to be proving identities, which you will later on see that they are very super useful in proving other stuff. And so let's proceed with our first one, that A minus B is equal to A intersection B complement. And a Venn diagram always helps. So let this be the U. This is A, this is B. And you'll see that A minus B is all this region. And if you say it's actually right that it's A intersection with B complement, but we'll approach our old analytical way. Let X belongs to A minus B, and this means that X belongs to A. Yes, X belongs to A, and X does not belongs to B. X does not belongs to B. So X belongs to A and X belongs to B complement, which means that X belongs to A intersection B complement. And that was pretty straightforward and easy. Next we come on to the distributive laws. And as you'll see, it's like that union distributes over intersection, or a symmetric difference distributes over union and all that stuff. Out of the four, we are going to here prove those two. First, let us see A union B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection A union C. And we'll prove it. Let X belongs to A union B intersection C. This means X belongs to A, or X belongs to B and X belongs to C. And this means that X belongs to A, or X belongs to B and X belongs to A, or X belongs to C. As you see, there are many possible conditions, like if X belongs to A, that then these two will be fulfilled. And when this, since this is a OR and this is a OR, it would be like X, yeah, X is in this, X is in this, and it's an AND, so this condition is fulfilled. Or X is going to belong to B and X is going to belong to C, which means that these and this condition is going to be fulfilled. With OR, it will be like, yeah, these both are true, and since between an AND, it would be fully satisfied. And hence, from here we get our state: X belongs to A union B and X belongs to A union C. And from there, X belongs to A union B and A union C. And we prove the first type of distributive law. Now let's see the second one. In this, we are going to be proving that A minus B intersection C is equal to A minus B union A minus C. And that's not exactly like distributive law, but it's help. And this we don't require to take that X belongs to. It can be done pretty simply, as we'll see. So A minus B intersection C, it is actually equal to A intersection B intersection C whole complement. I told you that these identities are going to be very important. So A intersection B intersection union C intersection, and that, if you remember, is our old De Morgan's law. And further going, using the distributive law we proved earlier just now, it's A intersection B complement union A intersection C complement. And if you guess, it's A minus B union A minus C. And the second one also can be proved in a similar way. So we approve that.